The Indo-Pacific region is predominantly a maritime space, straddling across both Indian and the Pacific Ocean. Though I chose to use the word predominantly maritime, I do not intend to underplay the significant continental connotation of this region. I am sure the audience is well apprised of the factors that make the Indo-Pacific region the nucleus of global geopolitics and geoeconomics in the 21st century. The rapid and robust economic development in the region has catalyzed an accompanying widespread military buildup. While such trends are not unusual, a high degree of ambiguity in the strategic intentions of such nations remains a concern. Consequently, the region is facing a deficit of trust, giving rise to widespread unpredictability and in some sectors, even instability. This, ladies and gentlemen, is what we must seek to address. It is the shared vision of almost all stakeholders in the Indo-Pacific to establish an environment of peace and security. In India's context, this is enshrined in the vision of Sagar, as articulated by our Honorable Prime Minister. Sagar literally means the ocean and stands for security and growth for all in the region. And the Indian Navy accordingly seeks to work in close coordination with other stakeholders in the region to build up mutual understanding, trust, and interoperability. This would then allow us to evolve mechanisms to complement each other's effort and thereby ensure a favorable and a positive security environment. Simultaneously, we seek to promote adherence to established international law and respect for mechanisms through which these are enforced. We believe that such an approach will allow nations of the region to actively pursue their own interests freely and also ensure collective peace and prosperity. Going forward, we seek to work closely with regional nations towards establishing transparency and openness. Transparency is key to lasting peace. For transparency to exist, a constant dialogue is essential, and initiatives such as the Indian Ocean Naval Symposium, the recently held Goa Maritime Conclave, or the Milan series of exercises in the Andamans are aimed at providing platforms for interaction, and we will continue to lay thrust on these constructive dialogues. Exercises such as Malabar, GIMEX, OS Index with like-minded nations are extremely useful for fostering cooperation and interoperability, thereby enhancing transparency, something that my co-panelist will also vouch for. This would in due course facilitate policy coordination. In recent times, national leaders across the Indo-Pacific have displayed a distinct maritime inclination in their outlook. Such conversion of views amongst national leaderships must be taken forward by respective maritime agencies. Now, let me highlight some challenges that we would encounter. The first challenge that we need to overcome while formulating multilateral institutions or shaping coalitions is the diversity of the region, be it political, cultural, or economic.